Hey everyone, Pastor Nathan here. Christine DeMarco sings a song called Take Courage. And the chorus line of the song goes, "Take courage, my heart, stay steadfast, my soul. He's in the waiting." This is a season that has been described one of like waiting. At least the people I talk to from Epiphany and I interact with say like, well, it just feels like the same day over and over again, that some folks are having trouble keeping track of what day of the week it is. How long have we been in this season of social or physical distancing, where we are kind of locked down to a certain extent? Like, it's hard to keep track of time because the ways that we used to measure our weeks are not, in some cases, are not there anymore, and we're developing new rhythms, new habits along the way. But the song got me thinking, especially about our gospel text a couple weekends back. Our God is in the waiting, and he makes his people wait. He makes the disciples wait until the very end of Easter. He doesn't show up Sunday morning to all of the disciples. He makes them wait till the evening. He makes Thomas wait a whole week before he confirms that, yes, he really is back. He makes the disciples wait 10 days after he's left before he sends them the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. Jesus ascends on day 40, and on day 50 is when Pentecost arrives and the Holy Spirit shows up. God makes his own son wait 30 years after he was born before he sends his son out on his mission, before Jesus is baptized in the Jordan River and inaugurates his three-year mission. Our God is one who acts in his own time, and he sometimes makes his people wait. COVID-19 is not the only place where we wait. Sometimes we have to wait for a dream to be fulfilled. Sometimes we have to wait a long time for our God to show us the direction he wants us to go. But the encouragement that I take from Scripture, as Christine DeMarco points out in her song, is that he's in the waiting. Just because we're waiting doesn't mean our God has abandoned us or is ignoring us or has forgotten about us. In fact, he's refining us in the midst of that waiting. He's preparing us in the midst of that season in order to make us ready for whatever he's got for us next. He is active in the midst of that season where we wait and we anticipate and we hope. So my encouragement to you today is this. In this season of waiting, look for places where God is preparing you. See how he is honing you and sharpening you and refining you as you spend more time with your families, as you spend time trying to develop new rhythms and new habits, that you see him and his work as he's preparing and shaping you and even indeed Epiphany as a whole for whatever comes next. So I hope that's helpful for you as you go about this day. Have a great rest of the day in our Lord Jesus Christ, and we'll talk soon.